Tech Rabbit here again. Thought today we could do an unboxing of a Parkside angle grinder. Now I think most of you are gonna leave the video. But nope, wait, I got some bonus stuff. Going to try and use one of these. This is put it onto the angle grinder stand and see how it works. Anyway, well, so we just unbox the angle grinder first. See what we get. Probably pretty standard. I paid for this. Oh, that's actually bigger than I thought. It is heavy. Surprisingly heavy. And it comes with some kind of a cutting blade. Steel. So one steel cutting blade and then the handle. That's some kind of a. Oh, that's neat. Look. You put the actual tool for the taking the blade on and off in the handle. Oh, that's a neat invention. And it comes with spare brushes because it's not a brushless unit, but I mean, you don't get brushes with that price. Anyway, whatever. Boring. Looks like that. Everybody's, I think pretty much everybody's who's been doing any kind of hobby work has a grinder used it, so I don't think this is all that super interesting. So we just park that there. The main interesting thing is this. Knife because it's taped in. Let's hope I didn't knock the camera too much. Should have prepared better. Yeah. This is heavy, so I'll put that out of the way. Okay, let's see what we've got. That's quite a lot of parts and tools and nuts and bolts. Manual. The idea with this stand is that you can turn it into a smaller cutter, so you can actually cut smaller diameter pipes and rods and stuff. And that will be useful because I'm a bit tired of using the hacksaw to saw through like threaded rod, 5mm threaded rod. It gets to be a bit more after a while. Together before, so we'll see how this goes. Maybe I'll have to do some. If it gets too complicated, I'll do some video magic. Get it built. Sequence of pictures. It's again describing in text how to put this together. Duh. This is going to take a while. 20. So you should take the saddle, 21. not the easiest to put a bolt in. Oh, yes. Yes, they actually did. Thought I saw it. Well, it shows the problem. This is very tight space. Probably have to keep this around because this is a special Shorten Allen key. So it's probably the only one that's gonna fit in here. So you probably can't use standard Allen keys on that one at least. I don't know on this one in the back if you can actually see if one can get in. Manual for the rest of the steps and then come back. Up the spanner. I need to put the handle on. According to the instructions, it should just go in here. It's tight and nice, but I mean, if you look at the forming of the channel for it, you would think that the actual nut should go in there. But the thing is, there's no clear picture or sequence that says if the washer should be here at the bottom or at the top underneath the handle. There's no illustration. Fasten the handle 3 on the mount 24 with projecting screw thread and the corresponding nut. See figure A. And figure A does not really help. But as far as I can see, the washer shoe is where it's supposed to be. But I'm not 100% happy with that, but it will work. So, next. Okay, so it needs a specific thread for the... Now I need to find out what thread that is. This is the classical YouTuber mistake. I put the camera blocking my access to my measurement device, to the calipers, so now I have to actually shut off just the calipers. Rethink the positioning of the camera. This was very good for, or at least take the tools out first. Okay, what is this then? What does it say about the size? M6, M8, or M10. I'll say that's a M8. And we need to, put the cutting blade in the cutter. It does not say anything about what to do with the protection. I mean, the funny thing is that there's no picture where it shows this unit with the grinder already. I mean, I know there's many types of grinder, but they could have at least given one example picture. Let's see if I can find one. That's strange. Look at that. In the back sheet, they have it hidden away. So it actually looks like that. And you need to know that it's a lead that you turn. But I suppose it'll show in the instructions. Okay, here we go. It's still a little bit difficult to see if the actual grinder has its own protection on. Hard to say. Okay, but let's say that it's on and it's in the right position, just for argument's sake. I'm not going to put the blade on this thing. Okay, glue it. And then I do like this solution. It's actually in the handle. That's pretty bright. Do any other tricks? Oh, it comes off. Ah, okay. So I don't know why it comes. Why that comes off? Maybe store other things in there. Protection thing here. That's nice. Usually they can be actually not so thick, these. Oh god, that's heavy. Yeah, it's gonna work, and that's that. Okay, now back to it. So let's set the blade in it, and then we need to find out what thread the handle is. Hate it when they describe all these things with text. Then place the corresponding mounting bolts 8, washer 7 and matching nuts 9, distance pieces 10 and plastic bushing 6 on one side, ready for use. Insert the necessary plastic bushing 6 into the mounting pieces 10, 11, and 26. See figure B. Note, ensure the size of the plastic bushing 6 matches the required mounting bolts 8. Plastic bushings are not required for mounting bolts 7, 10, 8. Screw the maximum mounting. Oh, that's just what I meant. I mean, then you have to jump between the picture and the text and try and memorize what number is what component. I wonder if I should use video magic and then come back with a solution to this set of components. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Of course it'll drop out now. We will just assemble it just for a matter of sake of visual sanity. So that will be the first one. And then the second one. Like that. So, let's see what David likes to do. Thank you. Yeah, this is always interesting trying to figure these out. The short one. So short one. Oh, I need some more coal. Not easy to put together. Well, just, I told you to drop out. Can't really keep it in there. I just like to have it just for visual purposes. So I don't forget it. Okay, and that moves in that slot. Wherever it should go. In the front. It's a nightmare reading the instruction. It's actually easier to put this together without reading the instruction. They should have a sequence diagram with picture combined with real text, and not just having one picture and then a mass of numbers. And so. Of course, wash around underneath the shelf. But anyway, I screwed it in. That was actually quite fiddly to get the alignment in place. Well, now it's actually in. So So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to work with these adjustment screws. These two here, and then these ones on the back here, to get this stable in place and straight. And then we can. That's actually seems to be. You know, the positioning of this is a bit weird. Where is it lying? I think it's dimension-wise it'll work. It's just a bit floppy right now. So anyway, I'm going to fiddle with these two adjustments, get those bolted down, and then I think it'll actually be okay. And then I'll come back. Snapped. So that's useless. And then we have to adjust the just do a basic adjustment. On the clamp here, of course, it depends on what material you're cutting. And then I think I understand that this is the way that the extra, and this is, I presume, they intended it to be an extra guard so that you can actually, if you're mainly using this to cut things, that then it will catch the sparks coming out of the side. So I just put it on there like that. And then to get the blade orientated in this sort of sideways direction, then you need to adjust, disconnect these and push it down, so like that. And now I think it's pretty much there. I'm going to make a separate video where this is being used, because I can't use it in here or inside. I need to take it outside the garage. Well, we could see if the grinder starts. Wondering why I can't run a grinder in a garage. Because it's actually not used as a garage. Yeah, that's typical for our houses in our area. Okay, let's see if this one just to start the grinder. Disconnected that lead earlier. Oh. Just give me a little bit more lead and I can connect. That should be enough. This is a quite a good grinder. Well, good and good. It actually has speed controls. Really often see speed control on grinders. So anyway, that's done that one. Finished this project. It was a bit fiddly. Anyway, if you thought this video was interesting, consider subscribing. Press the bell button to be reminded of new videos. We'll continue making tool and other project videos as time progresses. And as I said, that if you don't want to miss the actual video where it shows this in action, then make sure you subscribe and press the bell button. Not bad. Price wise at least. Very cheap. And my main use for this, I must stress, is hobby cutting. I'm just going to mainly cut, you know, thin steel and aluminium, so that's... I don't know how well this combination would hold up in, you know, in real world usage, professional usage. Probably not that well. I think it'll work for me at least. Okay, well, see you in the next one. Oh, yes, of course, these need to be a bit free, so I think I'll free up this one. Thank you. this piece is going to be long enough. We did say to take the appropriate one. No, it might actually. No, I think I need to install this and test that. Change it out. Bolt, washer, distance piece. What? Ah, now it's now things are not going very well.
I have to go and find the washer.